Okay, in this video we're gonna explore Nokron, but first we gotta get this ball and then we're gonna gather some materials to be able to upgrade our spirit summons. You don't have to go over here. I just didn't remember what was over here, so I just wanted to see if there was anything else. Spirit ashes. They can be pretty good. Just to keep being people away from you. They are like maybe heavy. Right here to the left, that was a pretty nice view too. I like the stars in this area, even though they're not technically stars, it's an underground area. So coming up, this boss can be pretty hard or pretty easy. And to make it easy, you just take off your weapons. To make it even easier, take off all your armor and make sure you don't have any like items that can damage, because the boss is basically yourself. And once the boss becomes yourself, you can put on a weapon and it's basically you against them. An unarmed opponent. And this guy, you could basically use him to practice against fighting like different weapons, as long as you don't kill him. Keep practicing so you can get better, or you can learn moves that you can do with certain weapons. And you're welcome to explore this area up ahead. I'm mainly just gonna get some materials, but there is a boss that you can basically summon if you light up these pillars that I'm gonna run by. I forget how many there are. I think it's like 5 or 6, but if you light them all up, fight one boss. Maybe we'll do it later. I'm not sure yet though. And over here there's the red wolf. They are pretty aggressive. So I try to avoid those guys. They don't drop as many runes. And then over here, just gonna get down there so we can get another material to upgrade our summons. Get an item that works well with magician build or magic build. I don't know if we'll use it, but it's the spirit flame, but it is another option that you can use. And over here, we're gonna jump over and then here I died because of the camera. It just switched. So be careful, sometimes in the corners the camera switches. Here we get one of the web blades, which allows us to infuse our weapon with like blood, poison, and occult. And here is the item we want, the mimic summon. And we're also gonna do Ranni's questline, so we're just gonna continue. This ball right here can kill you, especially if it corners you. I've heard that you can go into the corners and you can survive. I haven't tried it myself, but since we are magician or wizard, we can just do our spells. And then that's probably the best because it kind of like. Over here we're just gonna get the side of grace just in case, and then we're gonna run past these enemies. Some of these guys transform, so if you want to fight them, try to do it one at a time, or else it can get pretty overwhelming. This last one becomes a giant. We're gonna come get this item over here that we need to give Ranni. And we also get a ghost over. Which is the last one we need for a level 10 summon. Side of grace that lets you go to a different area if you want to continue an NPC's questline or explore a different area. We're not going to do it right now. We may do it later to get extra runes. I also think the boss over there will be pretty tough right now since it's two of them. So we're just gonna give the item to Ranni, and this will allow us to progress our quest, and it should open the other tower that we couldn't get into before.
Ah, not blue.
Even in my-
It is in thy possession.
My thanks. Soon must I-
Ah.
My
a strange
I am so
I must thank
you may
it was but
what
I too am
the item that we just got allows us access to a different area which allows us to get the intelligence talisman which boosts our intelligence plus 5 and also a piece of the death rune which is used for another ending, and it was the other area that we're not going to right now. So in this tower there is a chest with another armor, Ranni's armor, and the headpiece boosts the damage of frost spells, so it could be useful if you want to use frost spells. We'll probably get that on. And then at the top there's a portal. Just allow us to go to a different area of Nokrum. So here we want to pick up this item, which is miniature Ranni. And then we go to the Grace and we talk to her.
Is it me thy?
I had an
but now the
perform
eliminate the name of
I will
eliminate the name of
I will not.
So now that we talk to her and keep going, we're gonna gather some more material here, which will allow us to further upgrade or summon. Also, be careful. This hanging from the ceiling, you can do a lot of damage if you're not careful, and heal stun you sometimes. But as long as you're hiding behind the wall, like, you'll be okay. This frenzy plant one. If you use fire against it, it'll attack even worse. So be careful with that if you do want to beat it for some reason. And then we can beat this guy, and he'll drop number 7, Soundless Stone. And I usually run past these guys because they're pretty tough. And it's pretty time consuming and they drop little souls. These ants over here, they do a lot of damage. I think I get hit by one of them. But if you get hit, just make sure you there's two shots and you'll die. Probably could have used the same spell for the previous one. We can kill him easily. But the one with the shield hit, it's a tough one. And I've been killed by this one many times. Different playthroughs. I got careless. Just keep your distance on both sides. And then, because if you just keep getting hit by it, and it'll do a lot of damage. You can either go over there and get the weapon we're gonna get in a bit. Or you can come get the grace. That way you go back and you can just teleport back to this grace, which is what I'm gonna do. The weapon that we're gonna get could be another option or alternative to the one we're using right now. Since it is intelligence scaling weapon. It's a curved sword. So it's a little faster. It does less damage. But it gives you a different option or approach. This guy should be weaker than the one we just fought, so he doesn't do as much damage. But we want to beat him this journey a little easier. And you can also explore the area below us if you want to. There is some items that you can get, and there's a another boss that you can beat. And that's the way you come back. So you can go back to the Grace. Again, we want to talk to Ranni at the Grace.
Let us speak of the past a while. I was of the Dem, each of us, which is when I, but I would not, I stole, I would not, the two fi- and the baleful, I too, the baleful, I too, the baleful sh-
And then, you can explore up here, to the left. I don't think we need to, but there is a golden seed you can get at the end, so that could be a reason to explore. And in this area, you can try to beat all these guys with spells, as you'll see in a bit. Just jump down. Yeah, it wasn't the best idea. The ones that are have electricity around them, if you kill them from above, they'll just create like a shockwave. It'll kill quite a few of them, and that's what I try to do here. One, it gets rid of more, and they leave me alone. And you can hear it, they're still dying. But it would have been safer if I would have done it from the top. Up ahead, we're gonna get another side of Grace. And just gotta make sure we talk to Ranni. I believe this is the last time. And if you grabbed all these ghost globerts that we picked up along the way, we should have at least 8 of the needed ones. We get our plus 10 summon. And then here, make sure you beat all these guys. They do cast Deathblight, which if it builds up, you die. Pretty cool way to die. If you want to see it, you could try it out. Once you do that, don't try to go too far out of the cave. Once you see him, you can try shooting spells and just kind of lure him into the cave.
Thou art the last. Tell the two fingers that Ranni the witch cometh to rend thy flesh with a fateful wound ne'er to heal.
You don't want to get too close to him. He has a combo or a combo that will just continue to hit you, and it's hard to dodge. But if you keep him at a distance, like, he'll stop and you could just hit him with spells. I
beautifully fought. My thanks. 'Twas more of a challenge than I envisioned. Now I can finally stand before them. This is farewell, my dear. Tell Blythe and E.G. I love them.
So that key is for the chest in Renala's boss area. And we'll go back to it later, because we need to open that chest to progress Ranni's quest. And then this is one of the areas a lot of players hate, because you have to run through this lake of rot. So now that we're back here, we need to buy, I think it's the first two.
Greeting, are you here for spirit?
Ghost Glowbird to be able to upgrade our mimic tier. And if you saved all the runes that we got along the way, we should be able to do most of it, because it does get pretty expensive the higher the level of the mimic.
Greeting, are you here for
Then I also remembered we gotta upgrade our future staff, so that's why I get extra runes. And we should be able to upgrade it to +7 at this moment, but we can't use it yet. And then we should be able to get the +10 mimic tier now, and then we just want to equip it, and that will be it for this video.